Hi everyone, Dr. J here, and in this video I'm going to briefly introduce what we'll be talking about in this module on electrical resistivity. Now, resistivity is a very widely used technique in near surface geophysics, perhaps the most widely used technique outside of the oil and gas industry. And resistivity measures the electrical properties of the subsurface, or the electrical structure of the subsurface, and we can use it to work out geological structure. And this is similar to what we did with seismics. So in seismic, we were using sound waves or vibrations that were traveling through the subsurface. We would pick those up on geophones and use that to infer layers, boundaries, and velocities. In this case, we're going to be inferring resistivity, which is an electrical property of geological materials, as well as other materials. And it can be measured using multiple methods. So this is one of the benefits of resistivity. Electrical resistivity tomography is one method that we'll use in this class, but there are other methods, such as magnetotellurics or EM. So one of the benefits of having multiple methods to measure a single parameter, like resistivity, is that you can verify what one method results using the other one. Resistivity is also useful because geological materials have very widely varying resistivities, anywhere from silver on one end of the spectrum at 10 to the minus 8 ohmmeter resistivity, so a very conductive material, all the way up to pure sulfur, which has 10 to the 16 ohmmeters, according to the book. So this wide range of resistivities means that there are good contrasts in the subsurface, depending on what the materials are, that we can use to infer those structures, or that makes the structures clearer to see. Now, of course, most common geologic materials won't have quite that large of a range. So granite can be anywhere from a few hundred to a million ohmmeter resistance or resistivity. Shales might be 20 to 2,000, hydrocarbon reservoir around 25 ohmmeters, sandstones a few hundred, topsoil could be a few hundred to 1,000 or so. And one of the real benefits of resistivity surveying is that water is easy to detect if it contains dissolved ions. So pure distilled water is actually quite resistive, but once you introduce any type of salts or ions of any sort into water, it becomes very conductive. And so it's very easy to see, for example, a leaking plume that will show up as a large anomaly in a resistivity survey. So in terms of what we'll be covering, in terms of topics, we have some basic theory that's gone over in the book, as well as some information on different types of arrays and how they're designed, as well as how they're deployed in the field. We'll be talking about some interpretation methods, whether that's just looking at the data and seeing the anomalies or actually doing an inversion, as well as a few case studies that are presented in the book. In terms of what we'll be doing for requirements of the module, we'll be split up into 2 weeks, so we'll have a quiz and a reading for each week. There'll be one homework, which has some basic problems about array design and as well as about the different types of arrays. And then we'll have a lab where we're going to use electrical resistivity tomography, or ERT, to detect subsurface structures. So that'll be kind of the layout of this module, and feel free to post questions on Piazza if you have questions about the reading or the content. I'll have some videos on resistivity. I'll use some videos from YouTube as well to cover different topics. So that about wraps up our overview of the module, and I will see you in the next video.